Hi Vaishali, how are you?
I'm fine, Julie. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to be on your podcast. I mean, it really means a lot to me.
So Vaishali Choksi is joining us from On Course. Vaishali, welcome to Emerging Trends.
Thank you so much.
So Vaishali, do you want to tell our viewers about your journey?
Yeah, so as Vaishali Choksi and On Course, my journey has been, you know, largely intertwined. And it's like a textbook example of, where the journey is as beautiful as the destination. And I began with this organization almost 10 years ago. And at that point, we were just a handful of people. And the company started with the aim of sending students abroad to achieve their undergraduate dreams. And through these years, I've seen this baby grow literally, like from those handful of people to more than 50 working with us today. And, you know, now we are not just into undergraduate studies. We help with master's applications, MBA, PhD. We also have diversified into SAT, ACT, GMAT coaching. And like, you know, when the company started, we were catering to clients only from Mumbai, Ahmedabad and Delhi.
Okay.
And now we have presence, like not physical presence, but yes, we have clients from across the world. So it's definitely been a beautiful journey. I've grown with the company and, you know, the company's grown with me. So yes, it's definitely, the journey's been as beautiful as the destination.
That is fantastic. So Vaishali, since we are talking about post-COVID world, you know, and emerging trends post-COVID, so what are the challenges as a business you faced post-COVID?
You know, to be honest, the pandemic has not been as harsh on us as with other companies, largely because we've been working on an online model since a while. Like our services used to take place through our office in Mumbai and Delhi, and that used to take place initially through phone calls and Skype. So the transition for us has not been that bad as it would have been for other people. In fact, the pandemic has actually given us a chance to, you know, connect with a larger audience. Our challenges, I think, as a company, On Course has not faced a lot. But as a person, I think, yes, it's been challenging. I had the COVID too last month, and it is an ordeal to go through that situation. And you're constantly in a state of worry on how to protect your loved ones from this. But professionally, with God's grace, you know, we managed to adapt to the post-pandemic situation easily because we were already on an online model.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I think it has become very important because due to COVID, a lot of tests and all the centers were closed. And a lot of students are in a dilemma at the moment that how to go about it and what to do. Do you have any advice to those students?
Yeah, so, you know, this is interesting. We, like our coaching center, which we call UPrep, it largely does SAT, ACT and GMAT coaching. So in the last 2 or 3 years, we had like a full-fledged coaching center in Mumbai, one in Worli, another one in the suburbs, with almost 20 to 30 kids attending every day in each batch. And we were trying to expand to other centers through Zoom. And this was before the pandemic. And at that time, people were very, very apprehensive about an online class. But now, I think it worked in our favor. So it's become so much easier for us to have Zoom classes. Like, we have this product on UPrep which caters to SAT testing, right? So every Sunday we have about more than 50 kids on our SAT testing portal. They log in onto Zoom and our teachers conduct like an actual test. It gives you the stimulation that you need for like a real-time test. And it's helping us, you know, it's also helping the students by and large. They're safer, and it also helps them adapt to their school routine, because when you get used to a one-on-one class on Zoom, it also translates to their school routine to other classes. So yeah, and these all, you know, Zoom, Google Meet, they're pretty interactive. You can screen share, you can record classes. So yeah, I mean, it's not all that bad. And for us, it's been a positive, actually.
So as on course, I mean, what are the long-term challenges what are the long-term consequences would you be looking at?
Yeah. So consequences is actually a better word because, you know, as I said, because we were on an online model, the challenges have been fewer. Primarily, we've seen that with the use of technology, we've been able to convince people that, yes, this online model really works. And as we were using it before, and now it's becoming easier for us to convince people that, yes, it's okay if your mentors are based in Mumbai or Delhi, you don't really need a physical presence. So that's been one huge advantage. The second advantage, as I mentioned, was, you know, the UPrep has benefited largely because of Zoom classes. We were not able to tap remote markets initially pre-pandemic, but because of the pandemic, now we are having clients on Zoom from across India. And like one of the biggest positives that the pandemic gave us was international presence. Like we have, like our mentors would travel to Dubai, Antwerp, Hong Kong. These are three main international client bases. And they would have to go physically to connect with the clients, hold seminars, things like that. But thankfully, because of the pandemic, we've been able to connect with them through Zoom calls, through webinars, and it's working well. So, yeah, I mean, I wouldn't use the word challenge. It's actually a plus that for us.
So I think you already talked about this, but let us discuss a little more. Creating de-risking is a new concept which is coming up post-pandemic.
Right.
So, what's your take on it?
So, you know, de-risking for us, what we've figured is that the biggest competition or the biggest risk in any industry is competition, right? So for us, de-risking, what we've realized is that we need to grow. Like, just to give you an example that, you know, when we started, we were probably just one or two companies in Ahmedabad that were doing undergraduate studies. And then now it's like mushroom growth happening with, you know, people doing it dime a dozen, not necessary. The quality is obviously going to suffer. So for us, what we realized is that to de-risk, we need a both horizontal as well as vertical growth. Vertically, we grew as a company by offering newer products. So we grew from undergraduate studies to postgrad, MBA, PhD, and it's a matter of, you know, pleasure, pride, whatever you call it, when kids who've done undergrad with you, and then they reapply for masters, they then after a couple of years, they come back with an MBA. So that way that vertical growth helps. We've also expanded to a lot of different products, like there's UPrep for coaching, but just other than that, we do a lot of seminars. There's a smart money seminar where we have like real time talking about money, how kids, and this is for kids as young as grade 8, right? And where we teach them budgeting, we teach them different investment options, and it's all goes real time. So it's not like with real money, but, you know, more like numbers, and we update it's like a very simulated game kind of a thing that happens. Then we have creative writing. So there's a lot happening other than just applications with OnCourse. And horizontally also, you know, we've diversified. So from a company that was just in 2 or 3 centers, we were pan India, and now we are moving, like, other than Dubai, Antwerp and Hong Kong, you know, I can safely say that we have clients from all different continents, obviously except Antarctica. But that's de-risking for us, having different clients and different products.
Yeah, that is fantastic. And I wish you good luck with including new services into OnCourse.
Thank you so much.
So thank you, Vaishali, for taking out time and giving us this interview. I'm sure that young girls around the world would be very interested in what you talked about.
Yes.
If you are viewing my channel for the first time, we have wonderful girls like Vaishali on this platform on a regular basis. So do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much, Vaishali.
Thank you so much, Julie. It was a pleasure.